We are oblivious to our certain demise. Earth is becoming desolate. Let me rephrase that. We are making the Earth desolate. The Earth on the verge of a mass extinction. Even though if you didn't acknowledge all the species that are already extinct because of our activities, there are 1 more million species under threat of extinction because of us in the next 30 years. We are so efficient and loyal to one thing, that to destroy. We are doing it without any speciation. We're going to successfully wipe out everything, including ourselves. The human delusion is that we are an independent entity, that we can survive alone, and everything is there to fulfill our needs, and the resources are limitless. But unfortunately, resources are limited, and we all are connected. It's called an ecosystem. We are not evolving to the changing climate, because evolution doesn't happen in mere decades. Our technologies can keep us alive for some time till we run out of resources, or find a way to harness the natural energy efficiently so we can reverse everything. Global warming. You may think this is not the time to pay attention to this in the middle of a pandemic. I beg to differ. This is the best time to talk about this. Now we know how things can go haywire when nature takes its course. Most of us don't have an idea or at least care about global warming and how close are we to collapse. Because we have this misconception, individually we are not responsible and we cannot do anything. Along with industrial revolution, we opened up the floodgates for human progress and environment destruction. Bad planning, human error got us to this point. Because we never think about coexisting, it's all about existing and dominating. Earth faced 5 mass extinctions. The 6th mass extinction is special because we are the reason. To get a better idea, read 6th Mass Extinction by Elizabeth Kolbe or watch the Netflix special Our Planet by David Attenborough. It can give you a spine-chilling truth of what we have done so far. In the last 40 years, we annihilated half of the wildlife. Habitat destruction is the number one cause. Globally, the animal agriculture is the biggest user of land. Animal agriculture. This produces more greenhouse emissions than the entire global transportation sector. 36% of the crop production goes to feed this animal. With all the water, land and crops, only 12% return to our food system as meat and other animal products. Because of the increased level of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, the ocean's pH levels are dropping. That means oceans are acidifying. The creatures and plants can't adapt to the rapid changes. We didn't stop just from depleting the ocean by overfishing. We are dumping all the waste along with plastics. The plastic dumped in the ocean kills most animals. Some eat the plastic. The microplastic particles transfer to us when we eat the sea life. We yet to find out how consuming plastic is going to affect us. But for the animals, it's a suffering death. We are not recycling all the plastic because it's cheap to make new plastic. And some plastic are not recyclable because of its chemical composition. The plastic is the best and the worst invention. The burden upon us to manage it wisely. Some suggest we can farm fish, but apparently not like livestock. Sea life cannot be abused. Half of the plant production happens in the ocean. That means half of the oxygen production happens there. So we need the ocean with its pristine biodiversity. One of the outcomes of global warming is melting of glacier. Rising sea levels aside, the trapped methane gas is released to the atmosphere. This can accelerate the global warming process. One of the main reasons for all of this is the rocketing population growth. By 1800, the human population is just 1 billion. After 200 years, it's 7.5 billion. By 2050, there'll be 10 billion of us. Let me break it down. Now everything is fine. No water shortage, no food shortage, air is breathable for most of us, but this is not gonna be like this for long. In the next 30 years, there won't be enough resources. We are exhausting all the support systems that are vital for our existence. There's nothing noble we have to do. Just have to be selfish, just like we always are. Protect the environment to protect ourselves. There is no hippie agenda like save the planet, save the environment nonsense. Earth doesn't need our help, only we do. Without our technology, we're just puny meat bags. Our technology is great, but not great enough to erase our mistakes and destruction. Till we figure that out, we have to put a pin on our lust for animal products and plastic. If you pay attention, you know what to do as an individual to preserve the planet so we can eat it off a little longer. Smart people are already working on regenerating the earth. So what we can do is help ourselves by creating a balance. As a species, we are selfish and cruel, but not stupid. At least you are not. Since you made it to this point of the video, if you think this video can help create some awareness, please do share. Help yourself. Earth is changing. It's happening for billions of years. As an intelligent species, what we can do is not to speed it up. We are so disconnected from the nature. It doesn't mean we can thrive alone. We need the environment. We need the ecosystem. So we have to protect it. We all flawed. We all make mistakes. But to neglect this, don't keep your hopes high for a better future. Get along for a future. Good luck. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, share among your friends. Signing off, this is Zee.